My name is Maria, and this is my channel, Ella Juno's Crafty Corner. Today I am doing a stitch with me. I haven't done an actual stitch with me in a while. I've done quite a few lives, and I've posted a bunch of my Twitch on there. But I figure it is time to do an actual stitch with me. I am... I'm kind of out of what I need to say. I forgot what I need to say, and words are just not working today. So let's try to go again. If you are a new viewer here, thank you for coming in. I'm kind of sporadic. If you are a returning viewer, thank you for coming back. I hope you enjoy the stitch with me today. We are working on my rainbow dog. Really need to get this done before Christmas. And I'm like 52% and I have not had a stitchy bug. So I'm going to work on it during stitch with me and see if I can get some more progress done on this. It is Saturday, what is today? November the 19th. It is 2 PM for me. I changed my screen up a little bit. I kind of have, I'm going to change this up a little more. That is a little bigger than I want. Minimize these just a little. No, I don't want to move it. I want to minimize it. Make this more the center. That'll work. I like that. So let's update that. There we go. I think that works a little bit better. Don't move that. Ah! Sorry. Camera's moving. I decided since Simon was sleeping so prettily behind me that I would set up the video so that we could have a camera on him as well. I've seen it, a lot of people do that. We just recently rearranged the room around where I now have a bed in here. And he likes to sleep on the bed, so I figured I'd let everybody see him snooze. I do have another snoozing kitty near me. Just a second here. I'm going to move the camera just so, well no, she left. My bad. She was sleeping in the little thing up here, but she ran away. Oh, she's over there munching, it looks like. She might come back. But I had one sleeping beside me and one sleeping behind me. And I figured, why not show them? So, we are working on the rainbow dog. I believe this is 28 count, 2/1/10 stitch. I have not, like I stated, I have not been feeling stitchy. I have been knitting pretty consistently. Now, I will admit, I haven't done a whole lot of knitting or stitching in the last 2 or 3 days. I have been busy reading a couple of books. You know, just the romance books. There's really no I enjoy the storyline of them. This is something was not stitched right. Here. I'm right. If I'm a little low, I apologize. I think I have the volume all right on the microphone. But yeah, like I said, I've been reading, which I go through phases like that where I'll sit there and go through all the Kindle Unlimited books that I've been saving up, and I'll sit down and spend like 2 days clearing them out. Is there, in my opinion, they're not really that long. 2 or 3 hours to finish the book, because I read pretty fast. I've been told I do. So, yeah. So, like, I went through in the last 2 days. I've actually finished. I think it was four, five. It was five. I finished five books. Two of them were already pre-started, about 20% in. So, I mean, but the books were only about 200-300 pages a piece. And I was reading during work hours as well. So, yeah. But I will say, I have had a real hard time. Like, I want to stitch, I think about stitching, and then I get everything set up, and then it's just like, no, I really don't want to do this. I don't know. That most likely has a lot to do with knitting. I started knitting, so currently I have the knitting bug. It's like new and intriguing, and it's the reason I was afraid to start knitting in the first place, because I knew it was something that had intrigued me for a while, and I had a feeling it would take over. Just like cross stitch took over when I was doing bead work. But the difference is I actually really want to keep cross stitching. Unlike with the bead work, I just quit having any interest in it at all. I have all the beads still, but I haven't really wanted to do anything with them. And truthfully, the only thing I've wanted to do with the beads here recently is make like get the clasps that I need and make my own what are they called? Stitch markers. I want to make my own stitch markers with all the beads that I currently have and gem like trinkets and stuff like that. Like, I could make some. Where's my scissors? It fell down. Not the ones I was looking for, but they'll work. Right, so we are done with that in this area. Let me mark this off. And then let's move here. We go. Was my elbow? Or my shoulder, not my elbow. Sleepy Simon. He's a sleepyhead. Can't blame him. This weather makes me want to sleep too. It's 35 degrees outside right now. Not snowy or anything. It's pretty outside. It's cold. All right, so we are here. So to start my thread, I'm going to go down about 3 stitches away. I come up. One, two, go here. Now I'm going to go back down the hole I just came off. You got a nice pretty little loop. I'm gonna come up my other hole. Go through. Go. And there we go. And pull that up underneath just a little. There we go. Now it is ready to start stitching. Alrighty. I've also been getting back into playing games. I've started playing World of Warcraft again. I've run across a few friends who are getting back into it, so it's dragging me back into it. So we'll see how that goes. I have been enjoying playing, been playing the healers, the Shami in World of Warcraft, if you know anything about them. So they have a new race coming out with the new expansion, so you can play dragons, and the dragons are really cool. I will play one here and there, but it won't be a main for me. I just think it's cool. Does not feel like this year should be almost over. I swear. I mean, I feel like, I don't know, it feels like it's the middle, besides the weather, does not feel like it should be November going on to December. It's like, where did this year go? It left. Just don't know where it went. Am I upset that the year is over? No. I'm ready for the year to be over. Wasn't the greatest year. Wasn't as bad as a couple of years, but it was not the greatest year. I am glad that the year is over. Just doesn't feel like it should be over. Excuse me, sorry. But yeah, totally does not feel like this year should be over with. Yep, and there she goes. Where am I? Oh, I'm there. Went there. Here. Keeping my hands out of the way? I think so. Hope so. Not been paying that close of attention, so I apologize if my fingers have been getting in the way. I apologize for my fingernails. I did not paint my nails today. This was just kind of a spur of the moment. Let's do this stream. I was playing World of Warcraft and then decided that I needed to get some stitching done. I decided since I was going to be stitching anyway, I would do a video and chat with everybody while I did it. So I'm going to show you the other kitty and where she likes to sleep. Well, it is technically Simon's bed. And when he's ready to lay in it, whoever is laying in it gets loved to death. He will literally lick them until they finally move out of his spot, and then he'll curl up and go to sleep. But the camera that's on Simon will be moving, so cautious if you get sick watching camera move. But we've got a little bed right here. There she is. Harry's. Harry's. Hi, baby. She's like, don't touch me. So we'll take this back to him. I can pet on him. He's just like, oh He's like, oh yeah, pet on me. Aries is like, don't touch me. Aries is my middle daughter's cat. Aries only likes Simon because it's her brother. The other two cats we have, she likes to hiss at, and one of them she likes to hunt and chase around and pin her into a corner. There's no actual injuries, but it gets annoying. She will literally physically go hunt up this other cat, and the other cat is normally just hanging in one room and trying to stay out of everybody's way. I don't know. Far as I know, there's nothing I can really do besides separate them. You can only put one up so long before you start feeling like you don't want to keep punishing them. And sometimes they just gotta get out their aggression. I don't know. That's one of those things. Normally she's pretty good. They 90% of the time leave one another alone. Only when she happens to see her or gets in a, I don't know, a bad mood. Let me mark what I've done already. Mark, move. Alrighty. I went to my Stitchy Saturday thing. I met, I've mentioned him a few times before, but I met another YouTuber there. He came up to the Stitch with me. He'd been, he asked for recommendations of where to go stitch at. He had checked out the Always and Stitches where we go at to all the time. And it's like, come to the Stitch with me. So he actually came to the Stitch with me this week or last week, for last month or this month, sorry. And it was pretty cool. He was we actually had two new people there that day. Hold on. Then here, I'm doing these two. There was another new guy there that day. First time I had seen any actual males in the group, so that was kind of cool. And the thing that was kind of funny is the second guy that was there. Normally, when we're in the Stitchy group recently, there's they've had the long arm for the quilting machine running, and it was quiet that day, and we made a comment about how it's so quiet without that running in the background. Turns out he was actually the one that was in the quilting room running the long arm. So we all had a good laugh because we're just like, oh, that was you. pretty interesting. But Mr. Holic is a really good YouTuber. He does a lot of sampler type patterns. They look really cool. I really enjoyed looking at the one that he was working on when he was there. Now don't ask me the name of it, I have no clue. But I do believe it was a sow from the caterpillar? I think. Right. Marfettes. I have more of that over here, but I don't have enough thread for that, so I'm not going to worry about that. I think I have enough thread for that. I don't know. Might. Rotola. We're going to try it. We're going to try. I have to move the main camera over. No, not. There's not. I'm not gonna try it. We're gonna go back over to where I was. And next color. I didn't have them close. One of them. Where's the other one? Just a second. There we go. Mark that back down. See, we got pretty dog face. All right, 36, 26, 33, 26. I might try to do a Twitch video tonight. I don't know for sure. We will see. I haven't decided yet. I need to post, might have two videos go up today, because I do have my last Twitch video that I totally forgot to post up. Oh, there'll probably be two videos today, this one and the Stitch With Me, the knit video from Twitch. My last video, I actually had a good amount, to me, in my opinion, I had a decent amount of people in chatting with me. I had like 3-4 different people come in to chat with me that day. That was really cool. I've been enjoying my knitting. I started a brand new pattern. First time working with multiple colors, so that's been interesting. I'm trying to make sure I keep the right pattern and the right repeats and all that. My mom called me this morning, sent me a picture of some yarn she had found. Like, can you make me something out of this? And she wants a hoodie or a beanie and a scarf. Luckily, it was one of the decent sized ones. It's one of the Lion brand mandalas, I believe is what they're called. I think. I don't know. It's a variegated, like, changes color throughout the yarn. And, so, I'll be making her a beanie and a scarf. Words. So, told her I didn't give her a time frame on when they'd be done, though, because I know me. Like, I'll get to them. I have too many projects on the go. Same thing for my knitting is the same as my cross stitch. I have too many whips. I don't have as many as other people, but I still have quite a few. One over. There you go. But I don't know. I enjoy it. I will say it's easier to get knitting done during work hours on the simple projects. Not so much for the more complex projects. But you know, let's see. We are going to be pulling my camera. I'm just looking at the wrong location. My middle daughter is in high school. She's in 11th grade currently. She's been doing the online classes. She's got one more semester to go. But the problem is she's having a hard time with the classes because they're the classes that you're never going to use when you get older. So she has a real hard time doing the work. She keeps missing the classes. And she really is wanting to get out of working in Walmart. She's done with it. So we were discussing what her options are. So we have come up with the plan that we're going to go ahead and pull her out of high school. She's going to go get her GED. And since she wants to go into the same job I'm doing, the IT tech field, she's going to go to the same college I went to. And as long as she gets the grasp of everything and is able to pass and everything like that, I've already, you know, kind of threw out there that to my boss lady that my daughter wanted to get into the same field. as me. And she then told me to let her know and put her application in and let her know. She might not be able to get on with me, but we should, you know, she said she has no problem hiring. Don't have any problem hiring family members into the job. They like the way I work, and they figure she should have this pretty close to the same work ethics as I do, which, I mean, she's been working at Walmart for over a year now. And then the job before that, she was there for 6 months before she left it to go to Walmart because she needed more hours because they wouldn't, you know, they were only giving her about 15 hours a week. So 10 to 15 hours a week. So she went to Walmart so she could get around 20 hours a week. Ready. So we will go here. We are going to work right here. I wonder if I should scoot in so y'all can see a little better. One thing bad about doing the stitch with me is you can't give me your suggestions. Excuse me. Don't like about this new streaming program I've been using is I can't figure out how long. There it is. It's up there. I found it. How long I've been recording. I figured out where it was at. Yeah, I was in Needlebug's stream the other day and she was using this different program, so I figured I'd give it a try. So far, I like it. It's called Prism. Kind of cool. Where are we at? We are here. I'm going to come in here. I'll come up here. Yep. Go. So I have just a tip of thread. Back down. I got a pretty little loop. I go up, I go through that loop, pull up just a little taunt, we are under, there we go, we are sealed. Blurred on me. I don't know if my hand was just too close or what. Has it been doing that? It has, I apologize. not like being up that close. 1, 2, 3, skip. Let's see, what else? Don't really have a whole lot more to talk about. This one. Nothing on the back. Oh, you thought you were in a knot. I fixed you. Haha. Alright. Sorry I went quiet there. Like I said, I've kind of talked about most of anything I needed to talk about that I know of. I don't do, like, I have decided I'm not going to try to keep doing the early morning streams. I might wake up early and do a stitch with me or something like that, but there's nobody on Twitch or YouTube at that time. So I don't see the sense in trying to do a video at that time frame. So I know I was talking about doing that, but now I'm going to plan to do them in the evenings. I don't know exactly which evenings. I've been pretty consistent. I've been trying to be consistent on what days I stream. I did Monday this week. I've not done any more streams this week because I like literally lost all Stitchy Bug and Knitting Bug. I just got sucked into reading a book. Then I finished one book and then I would go right to the next one. So, yeah. But I'm going to try to stream. I think I'm going to go Monday nights, Thursday nights are the goal. If I throw an extra one in, just one gets thrown in. No plan for a third one. Stitch with me's, I'll probably try to do those. They'll probably be more of my weekend thing. Do a stitch with me on the weekend, maybe a live video, depending on if I can pre-plan. Unfortunately, I always seem to remember to think about planning a stitch with me well after. After. Let's go here. I think about it the morning of, so nobody has any time to plan to join my live videos on YouTube. So I'm going to try to remember to plan my videos so that I can sit there and say, hey, I'm streaming at this time, come say hi. I just don't like planning the video too soon and then something coming up and not being able to do it. I hate canceling the things I've already got planned. So we are ending this thread. Go up here. I'm going to tack it down underneath here. That's 187 stitches so far. Over here, I'm going to go with 310. So I'm going to use my already used thread. I don't figure going to take all, this will probably take all of this. It wouldn't take all of a brand new piece, so. I will say I'm not 100% sure if I'm going to go all the way down the pup's neck. Depends on, I don't know, depends on how close it gets to December, truthfully. I may stop just like right here. Maybe one more down. Might not go all the way down, because if I remember right, I still have about down to here to finish, like, down past here to finish this off. Got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more rows down to completely finish this off. So I might manually stop it myself. I don't know. We will see when I get closer to that area. But as of right now, so we're going. Here. There we go. Excuse me, sorry guys. Pulled my thread right on out of the loop. Give me just a second. I gotta redo that. Try that again. There we go. There we go. So. Again. extra thread. There we go. We're gonna go back down. Pull that down and under. Stitch. Now I'm going to pull this up under, back out of it. There we go. Alrighty, there we go. We are on the roll again. Yay! Down. Alrighty. All right. There we go. Alright, let's see. When I get done with this, I'm going to go figure out what we're doing for supper. Not supper, lunch. We didn't actually get up until about 11 o'clock today. So we had a late breakfast. So we'll eat lunch and then figure out what we're going to do for supper. So, I'm going to do this. Yep, we're going to just go on up. Still really love the look of this pattern. Even though I have not had a stitchy bug, I have enjoyed looking at my pattern. Haven't had the want to start any new patterns. I do look at my Hades and think I should work on those. They're not being worked on, but it's actually pulling them out to work on them that's been hardest. Because for one, I'm like, I need to finish these before I pull out any of those. Because I really do want to get these provided for Christmas gifts. What I think is funny is last year I started Christmas gifts, you know, late. And got them all done. This year, I actually started these early in the year. I never finished them. My grandpa's, if I don't get the yellow flower done, it's not that big of a deal because I do already have a project finished for him. I do have a project finished as well for my Aunt Janice. Let me see where I'm at here. Get there. Right there, right there. Here, here. Here. Yeah, okay. So now I'm just going across here. Thinking there was three rows here for a second. I did get one finished for my Aunt Janice. I did, I got the multi-cat done. So, but I really wanted to give them the cat and the dog this year. I don't know, just, plus I'm giving it to them for the whole family. So I want more than one thing for them. Next year I may give beanies out to everybody for Christmas. I'm enjoying making socks, but I don't know. It's kind of hard to plan to give socks to anybody. It's just like, don't know what size their feet actually is, and you don't want to ask because then you give away what you were wanting to make for them, especially when they know that you've started knitting, so they know some of the things that you can make. I was able to get my grandpa's size for a beanie because I finished my daughter Aylin's beanie, and we'd taken it over there. She wears that thing everywhere, so it's kind of cool to actually see her wear something I made. That's really cool. I enjoy it. But I had Grandpa put on her beanie so we could see, like, what the size difference was. Sneakily, I had made a comment that I could make him one if he wanted one. And he seemed to really want one, so I think it'd be a pretty cool Christmas present for him next year. If I can get one made, I could possibly have it ready for him for his birthday next year. His birthday is in February. So if I can finish the current beanie I'm working, I don't know. Ugh. Have so many ideas, but I don't have enough needles, and then I don't have enough time. So, yeah, life. Too many things, not enough time. All right, so I got that done. All right, that's 237 stitches. It's been about 53 minutes. I think I'm going to go ahead and call it because if the video is too long, it takes so long to load. So I know when I put my Twitch videos on there, it takes almost 2 hours for that thing to finally load through. So I think I'm going to go ahead and call it here. So this is where we're currently at on the dog. I've got a good view of the face. We're working on the mouth area here. I still have a good chunk to do over here on the ear. But like I said, this. I do think, I don't know. Might stop just below here, this row. Just level everything out to over here and see where it's at and what it looks like. Just so I know that it's done in time for Christmas. So, I don't know, I'm probably going to make it to where I don't go any lower than this box. And then we'll see how it looks. Alrighty, everybody. So that is the end of me. Simon has had a good hour nap. Uh-huh, yeah. Maybe he will probably continue to sleep there for the next 2 hours. And then we got Aries still sleeping up here. I don't know where the other two cats are. Reese's is probably in the room with Knox. And Ritzy is probably downstairs because that's where they tend to hang 90% of the time. So, all right. So I'm going to say goodbye, everybody. I hope everybody has a great week. And if I don't happen to get another video up, but I should. But hopefully everybody has had a great Thanksgiving. And I will see everybody next time. Bye, everybody.